Today I will explain about three-phase and one-phase autotransformer. Here I have shown single-phase normal transformer. It has two winding, primary and secondary. Flux circuit is common, but electrical circuit is different. They are isolated. In case of autotransformer, this winding will not be there. Only one winding will be there. Here I have shown. From this winding, we take a tap and this behaves like output. Here we connect a load, here we connect the AC input. Difference is, because there is no winding, so there is no isolation. This and this electrical circuit are connected together, but size of transformer becomes small. Voltage and current ratio and turn ratio formulas are same here and here, both places. V2 by V1 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to I1 by I2. And primary VA power V1 into I1 is equal to secondary power V2 I2. If turn is more, voltage is more, but current will be less. Here auto doesn't mean that automatic transformer. This auto is just a name and taken from Greek language. This is three-phase auto transformer. This is core. It has three winding, one for phase A, one for phase B, one for phase C. Each winding there is only one coil, not two. From that itself, here AC input will be connected and at typing output load will be connected. A normal transformer, there will be two winding, one primary, one secondary, but here only one. This I have shown here. One terminal of each winding is connected together and connected to neutral. This is a star connection. AC input we give here and load we connect here at this A2, V2 and C2 in a star mode. Step down, step up and variable auto transformer. This is step down transformer. Here we have connected AC input. At this point, this is called tapping. This is tapping, this is tapping, this is tapping. At output side, where load is connected, turns are less. If turns are less, voltage also will be less. The voltage is coming down. So it is called step down transformer. In this case, input voltage is connected here and load side connection is here. Load side turns are more, so voltage will be more. So it is called the step up transformer. In case of variable transformer, output type can be changed. Here it is fixed, here you can vary. Anywhere it is possible. Tapped auto transformer. In this auto transformer, 5 connections are shown. These points are called tapping. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tappings are there. At this tapping, I have connected AC input. Output can be here, 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 or here. If you connect output load here, you will get more voltage because turns are more, say plus 20%. This is just example. Here, plus 10% because turns are little more than this. Here, output turns are less compared to this. So, minus 10%. Here, minus 20%. So, this tap can be selected using this switch. See, now switch is connected here, plus 20%. I can rotate this switch. Now, it's connected to plus 10%. Now, connected to minus 10%. And now, connected to minus 20%. So using one switch, we can select any type what we want. Step up and down tap reversal. In this auto transformer, there are two tapping, one here, one here. Higher turn is connected to input. Lower turn connected to output. So here turn are less, the voltage will be less. So it is step down configuration. Now same transformer can be connected as a step up. I will show how. Now input is connected to lower turn tap and output load is connected to higher turn tap. So it is step up transformer because you will get more voltage here. So this change or reversal is done using switches. By this method, cost of the transformer can be reduced. I have one manual voltage stabilizer with auto cutoff. It has one auto transformer. This is input. Output, there are many tappings. This tapping can be selected using a switch. Switch has many positions, 1 to 8. There is another switch, up and down. If we select here, at up position, then it will behave like step up transformer. At down, it will behave like step down transformer. Now what happens? Because we are doing manually, we may do mistake. Input voltage may be high, still we may set at up position, the output voltage will go up. To protect from that, there is an auto cutoff. That is called over voltage protection. There is a circuit here, there is a relay. Using relay, it protects automatically. Three-phase tap auto transformer. It has three winding. One terminal of each winding is connected to neutral. So this connection are in star mode. Similarly, load also is connected in star. Each phase has three taps. In one tap, middle tap, I have connected AC input. Output, there are two taps, one for higher voltage, because turns are more than input turns, and one is lower voltage, because here turns are less than these turns. Now connection in three phase are done such that all output should be connected to either higher voltage or lower voltage. Not like that one plus 10%, one minus 10%. 10% I have written, it can be anything. So in this case, output is connected to higher type. B also higher type, C also higher voltage type. Now using a switch, you will change all three together. Now this output is connected to lower voltage, this also is connected to over voltage, this also connected to over voltage. So output should have similar type of connection, either higher voltage or lower voltage. Three phase variable auto transformer. In this three phase transformer, in all three phases output is variable. And input and load are connected in star. Now we have such arrangement always such that all three should move together such that output voltage at all three outputs should be same. So they are mechanically locked. In my case I will show how. At present voltage is like this. Now if I move down, voltage is coming down in all three phases. Now voltage is going up in all three phases. Now rating of transformer. Rating of this transformer is 240 volt 100 VA. Means we can give 240 volt at input and we can give maximum 100 VA load here. In case of variable transformer, we don't write VA here. We write only 1 ampere. Why? Suppose this is 240 volt 1 ampere transformer. So VA will come 240 VA. Now suppose output typing is here. In this case typing was known. In this case it can be anywhere. Suppose it is here at 10 volt. So at 10 volt we will require 24 ampere to make 240 VA. So if we write 240 VA, 24 ampere current will flow here. Then this transformer will burn. So that is why we don't identify VA in this variable auto transformer. We write only 1 ampere. Here you can give 1 ampere maximum. In case of 3 phase, if rating is 300 VA, means this is total. Each phase can have only 100 VA load. advantage and disadvantage. Advantage are small size because there is only one winding. So size will be less, weight will be less, cost will be less, copper saving will be there, better voltage regulation. In normal transformer, there will be two winding, each winding has its own impedance. So when the load current flows, drop will come here also, so regulation at this point will be poor. In auto, there is only one winding, only one impedance, so less drop. So we will have better voltage regulation if current change here in the load. Disadvantage, bigger disadvantage is no isolation. Now during fault, more current problem. Suppose this output gets short circuited. In normal transformer, this current will be limited by this impedance and this impedance both. In auto transformer, there is only one impedance to limit the current. So more current will flow here, more current problem. Wire break. If wire breaks here, then full voltage will come here. If there is a capacitor, then voltage will go up further. This is disadvantage. Then it is not economical for less voltage ratio. If voltage ratio is less at secondary, it is not economical. Usage. In house, we have lot of electrical items where we require voltage stabilizer. There are three types: automatic, manual, manual with over voltage protection. Just now I showed cutoff in my stabilizer. Then testing in lab, practically it is used, development it is used, in HV test lab it is used, in industry products are tested, for that testing it is used. Then starting of motors, this is used to reduce the current in motor during starting. Then speed control of fans, it can be used. Then in power system, for voltage regulation, it is used. Then there is a special type, zigzag type transformer, which is used for third harmonic filter and to generate earth reference point. This is zigzag type transformer. This is 33 kV line. This transformer terminal A, B, C are connected to A, B, C 3 high voltage line. Neutral is connected to ground. It has no load connected. It has no tapping, but it does the job. It's simply connected with the line. It is providing grounding and it will filter third harmonic also. Today we'll close here itself.